The formation of snowflakes starts high above the clouds in the troposphere. In several thousand meters altitude, the water is still gaseous, although the temperature is pretty low, approximately minus 40 degrees Celsius. Isolated water molecules are floating around, and sometimes they aggregate loosely but separate again then. The crystallization, the constitution of the smallest ice crystals, will only take place if there are, for instance, some dust particles. These dust particles are acting as so-called crystallization seeds. In order to understand in which particular way the water molecules aggregate, one has to look at their structure. Water is a bent molecule consisting of one oxygen and two hydrogen atoms. And these molecules have a so-called dipole moment. The oxygen, shown here in red, has a negative partial charge, and the hydrogen atoms, shown here in white, carry a positive partial charge. Charges with opposite signs are being attracted by each other. During the aggregation, the water molecules orient now in such a way that always a positive charge is directed to a negative charge. Together with the bent structure, hexagonal patterns appear. Water crystallizes in a hexagonal lattice, and this lattice determines the shape of the ice crystals. More and more water molecules aggregate. In the first place, hexagonal plates and columns are being generated. The lightweight plates initially rise further up and are being charmed away through turbulences, for instance. They grow constantly during that journey, and if they reach a certain size, they are so heavy that they begin to fall down again. From this point, every single snowflake grows differently, depending on the temperature and humidity of the respective air layers they are floating across. In slightly warmer and relatively arid regions, the ice crystal absorbs all water molecules from its near surrounding, and it grows most rapidly on the edges. The typical snowflake shape appears. This process is called diffusion-limited aggregation, DLA. A few hundred meters above the ground, the ice crystals do not grow any further. But on the way to the Earth, some crystals may get caught or freeze up. And this is, altogether, the reason why the snowflakes look like they are.